What's up, G-Show Land, and welcome to another episode of the G-Show Podcast. I am G1, and this is our Prey review. If you don't know what Prey is, it's the Hulu original movie that is a sequel to Predator. That's right, it is called Prey, and it is out. It is August 5th as of this recording, and I am joined by the one person that I know that has the most knowledge when it comes to the Predator franchise, the Yautjas, whatever you want to call it. Seriously, you have more knowledge than anybody else I know about this franchise. That's G73, my brother Megzy, my brother Chase. What's going on?
Oh, no, just a peaceful Friday. So,
peacefully.
Just hanging out.
Peaceful indeed. So, you know, Prey came out, and I know the both of us were very excited about this movie. We had, maybe in the beginning, I know definitely you probably saw more than I did. You know how I like to rock one trailer and that's it, I'm done. I don't want to see nothing else. We're good to go. But I did see, I think I seen an extended clip, if anything. And I wasn't mad that I saw that. I was like, all right, that's cool. And I was actually, you know, my curiosity was piqued even more. I remember early on in the marketing, or when the movie was even announced, a lot of people, you know how the internet gets, they start to like start throwing darts at it, like, a female, woke. God, Jesus, please, people, if the internet was a fucking thing in the 70s, I can't imagine there being so many sequels to Alien. I'm just saying. Could you imagine if they would have seen Ripley when computers was around and social media for the first time? Come on, man. Or even Terminator. Could you imagine if the internet was around in 1984 and these crazy dudes saw Sarah Connor, right? Meek little Sarah Connor kill a fucking robot? No, they'd have lost their shit. So, I mean, I don't get caught up in that shit. I'd rather wait till after the movie's done.
It's funny because every franchise that we like, Predator, Godzilla, King Kong, Aliens, the majority of those movies, females are the leads to all of those.
You know, it's funny, especially with the Japanese Godzilla movies. There's like a female protagonist in all of them. And
well, especially with Miki Sugusa.
Right, and nobody ever complains. That's the one thing, massive props to the Godzilla fandom on that. Because, you know, they love the movies in general. Yeah, some people might not like the Heisei movies. Some people might not like the Millennium movies. Some people might not like the Showa movies. And some people might not like the American movies. But as a whole, there's never any, like, beef or grief when it comes to, especially the Japanese movies, female characters in those movies. Because they do have leading roles. Even in the early ones. I mean, granted, they were quote-unquote secondary characters, but they played huge roles. You know, so kudos to that. But you're right. Like, the franchises we do love, there's female protagonists in these movies. I mean, again, I go back to Alien. Alien and Aliens especially. I mean, like, Ripley became a household name. Sarah Connor became a household name, especially after Terminator 2. Now, anything that came after those movies, there's an argument to be made. But I had no problem having a female protagonist in this particular movie, right? Granted, yes, that we've never seen a female protagonist in a Predator movie, but because of the setting, the time setting, the culture it involved, I was like, yeah, why not? Let's go for it. I mean, you could absolutely make a story about that. Ooh. But prefacing that, let's just give a quick little Predator universe overview, okay? If you would so indulge. 1987, right? Arnold Schwarzenegger and his merry band of, not mercenaries, because they're not mercenaries. They were rescuers or something like that. I forgot. They were a rescue team. Land in the jungles of Colombia. I'm pretty sure it was Colombia. To go and rescue.
Cambodia?
No, they were speaking Spanish. They go to rescue some U.S. asset, turns out to be a hoax. That's not really what they was there for. And
they're there to play cleanup.
Yeah, they're there to play cleanup. And then this alien species comes down, starts systematically taking them out one by one. I loved it. It's still, it holds up to this day. It holds up to this day until the last, you know, until the last dude, Arnold Schwarzenegger, obviously, goes to town. Not, let me rephrase that. He does not go to town. The Predator goes to town on him. And by a stroke of luck, he is able to defeat pretty much, at that moment in time on Earth, the ultimate life form. And it's a fucking classic. It's a classic. I mean, everything about that movie just works on so many levels. For people like us, an older generation, because I'm a lot older than you, but an older generation especially, I can see where some people seeing it today, the younger generation who are, you know, caught up in the political correctness, I get that. That's where
the older culture.
Right, and I see that's where, you know, a lot of people start hating on that. I can see them getting mad at Jesse Ventura saying, this shit right here make you a sexual Tyrannosaurus. But right before he says that, he calls them some shit like, something like, little lily-livered queer.
Slack-jawed faggots.
I could see where people...
Just Hawkins jokes alone.
Oh, yes.
About his girlfriend.
And her big kitty cat. Yes.
Yeah.
And that's the thing. I mean, I could see why people would get mad. But at the same time, I can't see why people would get mad. Because you got to understand, that movie was made in the 80s. It was a different culture, a different time. We weren't offended by shit like that. What we were there to watch was Arnold Schwarzenegger and these dudes fight off an alien menace. That was what was you know, promised us, and that's what was delivered. So, I mean, like, again, I can understand where they might get offended, but please, people, you have to, those who are easily offended, don't be offended by this stuff. It's a different time, and I don't say, oh, you can't use as an excuse. Yes, I can, because the movie's out. And, unless it was a George Lucas cut and they went in and they edited everything like a TV edit. No, that's not going to happen. But I digress.
It's just tiring to me because it's like, you, I mean, look, I get it. You know, people have different gripes of what affects them culturally and personally, but that's not everyone's. It's not everyone's responsibility to tiptoe around that for you.
Right.
And that's where it gets out of hand, is where if the slightest thing is said that makes you upset in a movie or done, you throw this fit and you're like, well, I have to boycott this because I strongly, firmly am against it, and I'm going to waste all my time and energy because I don't like it to point out that everyone that watches this should as well not like it at the same time. And that's just where I just disagree. It's like, look, jokes are jokes, you know, and culture is culture, whether, you know, you like it or not, it's not going to change for you specifically.
Agreed. Listen, at the end of the day, ladies and gentlemen, whether you like it or you don't, whether you respect it or you don't, you got to remember one thing. When these movies were made, most of y'all weren't even around yet. So go into a movie from like the early 80s, the 70s, go into those types of movies, especially genre flicks, with this mindset of, yeah, this was all about making money, not trying to put other people down. It was just Hollywood. That was how.
Back then, the culture didn't view stuff like that way.
Right, exactly. So I mean, everything was like, this is an action flick, this is an action sci-fi. Anyway, right. I digress. No more about the wokeness. I hope everybody just enjoys the ride. Period. Then we get to 1990s Predator 2, where they leave the real jungle for the concrete one, starring
the concrete jungle.
The concrete, starring Danny Glover, set in 1997, the future, my friend, the future, 1997, bro. When I see this movie the first time, I was like, 1997. Oh my God, that's so far away. It was 1990, it was 7 years away. Grow up. But I'm like, oh, and I'm like, what the hell's going on? LA is riddled with gang violence, right? Dirty streets.
Snorting gang lords.
Yeah, exactly. The police station is full of graffiti. The police station had graffiti all over.
King Willie.
Oh my God. That's right. The Jamaican voodoo King Willie. The Jamaican voodoo priest, King Willie. I still love that character.
I don't know who he is.
I love it. But that movie's my favorite one out of all of them. It is. I love Predator 1. I swear to God. No, well, I can never say anything wrong about Predator 1. There's nothing I can nitpick about that movie. It's a perfect movie, in my opinion. Predator 2, there's plenty to nitpick about. Plenty. But as far as, like, just personal enjoyment, I was telling my friend this earlier today about Predator 2 real quick. At that time, I had a fetish for what the future would be in films, right? So you had Back to the Future
showing us. I think everybody did at that time.
Exactly. And I think that's why they would make a movie from, like, 1990. Like, it was made in 1990, but set in 1997. Not too far away, but far away enough where we can make things change up a bit. So one of the biggest things that I used to love in filmmaking, in movies back then, especially when it was like set in the future, were guns. It was the weapons. So when I seen Danny Glover pull up in the beginning to fight those were Colombians, definitely, the Colombian cartel. And he pulls out this freaking hand cannon from his holster.
And it's with just the scope on it.
Yeah,
and shit.
And it's just a regular Magnum, right? But it's got the scope. There's like a another metal plate that makes it kind of look futuristic. This is the same shit that happened to me when the first time I saw RoboCop and his gun came out of his fucking thigh. I couldn't believe that. What is that gun? So I think that's what it was. I had a fetish for that type of shit. And I still kind of do because I was watching it the other day and I'm saying, why do I like this movie? Oh, look at that gun. But no, what Predator 2 did, again, they took it out of the jungle, put it in the streets of L.A. They followed the same themes. There was a common denominator. It was hot as shit. It seems like that's when these predators come to hunt in the intense heat. And I love that. I just following along with the story, continuing it, even mentioning Dutch. Whether they mentioned, I don't think, they didn't mention him by name, but Gary Busey's organization, they were tracking this thing. They knew that in 1987, one of them popped up in the jungles. And I just love that continuous flow, you know? It's set 10 years after the first movie, time-wise, in the movie. I loved it. And then, of course, the finale. Now, Greg,
I mean, you know, it's funny bringing that up, you know, on the subject of being, like, woke or politically correct. If you really wanted to be politically correct in a Predator movie, how about you make a Predator movie now based off on global warming? The Predator is going to look at Earth and just see it just red and was like, oh, boy.
Because that happens, and then it's not a Predator hunting movie. It's a Predator invasion movie. You know what I'm saying?
It's like, yeah, it's basically them going to like a hunting reserve, and yeah, it's like free game.
They're like, oh, you guys already terraformed it for us. Thanks. All right. Now we can bring the xenomorphs here again. But yeah, then we get to the point where, like, in Predator 2, I mean, I love this movie to death. I fucking adore this movie. But it's like, wait a minute. Danny Glover killed the Predator, but Arnold Schwarzenegger could? And Arnold Schwarzenegger's a bit... Don't get me wrong, though. Danny Glover's pretty big in that movie. I mean, he's not like Arnold Schwarzenegger monstrous and big and muscle-bound, but stature-wise, he's a big frame. He was a very big frame.
He's a broad man.
Very. And he brought some range and emotion to it, and that's one of the things that I picked up on this past week when I was watching it, especially when they killed John Paxton's character. And you see him in the subway, like, going towards the thing, and he's calling out for him. And then he hears the Predator and the scream, and he sees it. And he sees the Predator ripping out John Paxton's, you know, spine and just unceremoniously dumping his body onto the tracks. And there's this guttural yell that Danny Glover hits. He screams the name. And it punched me so hard. I was like, there was emotion, there was passion, and I really resonated with that. Plus, he had that big-ass hand cannon again. I digress. But it also gave us our first glimpse into the broader universe. I mean, the trophy room. Come on. Anybody who was a fan of the genre seeing that for the first time flipped their shit, especially at that time. Because you don't cross over movie characters like that. That's a no-no. That shit is reserved for Dracula, Frankenstein, and the Wolfman, or King Kong and Godzilla. And that was way back when. That shit wasn't a thing there. So when you get to see a xenomorph fucking skull in a Predator ship, you don't know what's going on, but what the fuck? I love it. And I guess that's that nostalgia trip, man. It's just perfect. Perfect.
Yeah, that was one of the coolest scenes. I always loved that about Predator, having the variety of skulls from different creatures and different planets and stuff and all that. I always, especially in the Predator Concrete Jungle video game, they have a section where they do that as well. Like, when you collect trophies from the bosses you kill, you can go and look at their skulls, and they're all detailed and stuff, and they tell you about them, like, what they are and why they were hunted and stuff. And they also have, like, a weapons wall, and I love that, too. I always love seeing Predator's variety of arsenal and stuff. It's like, I don't know, it's like the idea of Predator being able to kill things in different ways is always tasteful to me.
Agreed, and we're going to get to the arsenal in a minute, because I got a lot to say about that, especially for Prey. Then we got Predators.
Now hold on, you said John Paxton is...
Bill Paxton! Are
we talking about Jerry Lambert?
Yeah, Jerry!
Which is Bill?
Bill Paxton.
Bill Paxton?
Yeah. I don't know why I was saying John Paxton.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure.
Bill Paxton, that's it. Then we got Predators, Adrian Brody, a slew of other characters, getting dropped off on an alien, on a Predator game planet.
And we all forgot Alien versus Predator.
I'm not counting those. We're not talking about those.
Damn.
Nope. They don't count. Even though they do kind of count, they don't count. I'm just talking about the main Predator franchise. We got Predators, and I'll be honest, the other day as I was watching it, I kind of nodded out. I fell asleep. That was the first time I ever fell asleep. And it wasn't late or early. It was middle of the afternoon. And it just wasn't working for me. I don't know what it was, but I passed out. And I was kind of upset because I know, like, I do enjoy that movie. There are some really cool things about that movie. Especially the samurai.
Well, I mean, I feel the same way about Godzilla, King of the Monsters. But I love that movie too. But I'll fall asleep sometimes watching it.
Yeah, but the difference is you've also seen Godzilla King of the Monsters like 100,000 times.
Yeah, I've seen Predators 100,000 times too.
Not me, that's what I'm saying. Like, I only seen it like maybe 4 or 5 times, if that. And I'm usually, Predator 1 and 2, I watch those maybe twice a year because I love those two movies, you know? I do enjoy that movie. I do. I just fell asleep. I don't know what it was. You know where it was? It was when the dogs were chasing them. And then
when they first show up?
Yeah, and then Danny Trejo was like, help me. I love that scene. I passed out. I woke up and they were hanging out with Florence Fishburne. I was like, oh, what the fuck? I missed the chunk, you know, I was mad. And I didn't go back to it. I'm going to do that tonight. But you love Predators, right? You thought that was a...
Oh, yeah, I thought Predators was great. I mean, that movie's always going to hold a staple to me because I was, gosh, that was what, 2010 when that came out? 2009, 2010?
I think 10, you're right, yeah.
I just remember around that time when it came out, my dad took me and 10 of my friends to go see it.
Oh, that's dope.
Yeah, so we had a whole row of people filled, me and my friends sitting there, and my dad was there and stuff, so that was an experience. And then he bought us all lunch afterwards, and I'm like, damn, Dad, that was not a cheap ordeal.
Hell no.
And then Carl Jr. too, and I'm like, Carl Jr. is like the most expensive fast food you could have bought us.
Damn. Wow. Then you fast forward to what, 2018, if I'm not mistaken?
Yeah.
And we got Love Predator from Shane Black, a.k.a. The Hawkins. Hawkins from Predator 1.
The movie that should have been one of the coolest Predator movies ever.
I think I've seen it twice. I've seen it twice. I watched it in the theaters, and then I watched it when I got it on super dope discount 4K. I got it on 4K for like $5. So I was like, oh yeah, that's a five. It goes to the collection.
I can merit that that movie's not total terrible. There's a lot of cool stuff and a lot of great stuff, and the characters in that movie are great. Those were a great group of characters.
Agreed.
But it's just the things that once the fugitive predator dies, spoiler alert, when he gets beaten up by the berserker predator, again, that's probably the one thing I don't like is these bigger predators hunting the little ones, because predator is supposed to be an ultimate species in its own. It shouldn't have, I mean, there are in lore and comics predators that have gone rogue and different predators in this, but I don't know. I don't like the idea of a bigger predator. I would like an evenly matched other predator going up against another one so they're equal. You know, that would have been interesting. But once the fugitive predator's out, the movie for me just kind of gets silly. And, I mean, especially that ending when he gets the robot predator suit. That's my new suit, and it's like the fucking Iron Man of predators. And it's like, is this supposed to, like, one-shot predators and fly and all that? And has katanas and everything? It's like, man.
talk about jumping the shark. He's got it.
Making a statement.
Seriously, like,
I think I own Predators. I mean, The Predator. I think I have it on Blu-ray because I bought like a Blu-ray that came with all the Predators. I'm not too sure, but I can't remember exactly. But like I said, to me, not a terrible movie, but it's definitely my least favorite on the line of anything Predator related.
Agreed on that. That's how I feel with it. I mean, I didn't hate it outright like a lot of people did. But at the same time, I was just like, CG Predator? Really? Come on, man.
Come on.
And that's, you know, that was one of those things that, I mean, it rubbed me the wrong way. I was just like, nah. And I didn't like that look. I didn't like that design. I wasn't a fan. And that's...
That's you mean a fan of the Fugitive Predator or the Berserker?
The Berserker. I wasn't a fan, and that's the common theme here. That's the common theme. So, now we have our four Predator movies out of the way. 2022 today, August 5th, Hulu says, here's Prey. The prequel to all of these movies, pretty much, set in the way back times of the Native Americans, you know, roaming the plains of America. What did it say? Was it in the Dakota? Did they even give a
place? It said the Great Plains of North America.
That's all it said. Okay.
Yeah.
Perfect. You know what?
And it was like 1718 or something like that, or 1817, something like that.
You know what? That's perfect. There's the gamut right there. And, I mean, honestly, I love this theory. I love this idea. I absolutely love this idea, this concept, because yes, the predators do hunt, and we've seen it gradually progress in years with the movies, in story, you know what I mean? In the story timeline, it progresses. So let's go back in time. Why not? This is a great idea. This is a fantastic idea, because you can do so much with so many cultures, and it makes all the sense in the world to me. It makes all the sense in the world to me. So I love this concept right off the bat. I'm in. I'm hooked. And I can't wait to watch it. Well, 3 o'clock in the morning, I had to use the bathroom, got up, did a little pink, little tinkle. I said, well, I'm up. I mean, I got to get up in an hour anyway to start my day. So I might as well just throw this movie on and watch it now. And I did. And yeah, it starts off when I was in. I can't lie. I love the traditional Native American folklore. When she says, I saw a sign in the sky. I saw the Thunderbird.
The Thunderbird.
Oh, my God. I was like, yes. I loved all of that. I loved it. Oh, first off, just to get this out of the way, I thought the actors were fantastic. I loved every one of them. Everybody in that movie I loved. Even the guy with the bad teeth. I loved him too. I loved him. My favorite one was the dog. I gotta be honest. The dog was the
Sonny?
Best. Yo, that dog was on point. Like, I was like, who trained that dog?
He wasn't afraid of shit.
No, that dog was perfect. But no, I loved everybody in that movie. I was totally in that world. Like, everybody had me believing. There was some moments, though. I will say this. There were some moments in that movie where it seems like she breaks character to add a modern-day nuance, which I was no.
That's a great way to put it.
Yeah, and I was like, no, don't do that. Don't placate the today audience. You are a Native American woman back then. Back then. Okay, and I'm not talking about her rebellion or nothing like that. That's called pop progress. I'm talking about the actress taking it upon herself to do a little something that reminds you of something you would see today. And that's a uh-uh. That was a no.
She's trying to win the audience over to add personal things to herself to it, to make it be like, oh yeah, the spunk and attitude, we like that, to kind of make you get deeper into her character.
Right.
And then it takes those moments out of the movie and it makes it like kind of unbelievable.
Right. It's like, no, I don't. And again, we weren't around at that time. Neither were the filmmakers. Okay. But I highly doubt that's the way she would have been in certain scenes. It wasn't all through the movie. It wasn't. One or two scenes. And I'm not saying that ruined it for me. It did. It's just I picked up on it. And usually I don't pay attention to shit like that. But because this is a period piece, because this is set when it is set, her objective, which I loved, was y'all need to acknowledge, like, I need to be acknowledged as a hunter too. Like, I want to be acknowledged as a hunter. So I'm going to do whatever it takes to be acknowledged. She wasn't stupid with it, you know what I mean? But she also was like, yo, dude, I want to be a part of the fucking tribe this way. I don't want to cook or wash. I want to help hunt. I got nothing wrong with that. I see nothing wrong with that.
She wanted to prove herself more than just what they thought of her.
And here's where it gets crazy, because this is where a lot of people, right? And again, I don't mean to jump back on this topic, but this is where a lot of people be like, oh, that's stupid. That's not how it should be. No, it's not about that. She wasn't trying to take over anybody's position of power. She just wanted to be a part of the hunting team. It didn't matter.
She wanted to be viewed equal.
Yeah, it didn't matter if she was a fucking hangnail on the pinky toe of the team. She just wanted to be a part of it. That was it. I 100% respect that. 100% respect that. They got that point across in the movie. So, like, when you hear people saying, oh, it's too woke, it's too politically correct, either, no, it's not. She just did not fit in doing the laundry. Simple as that. But she would have no problem being the last person on the fucking totem pole. And that's what I love. She wasn't going after any particular title. She just wanted to be a hunter. She wanted to go out with the tribe and show, like, hey, I can do this. Let me help. I respected that. I really did like that. So that was really good. Again, all the actors I really enjoyed. Again, two, three instances that modern day nuance, I was like, nope, take that out. But, dude, when that motherfucker, I gotta tell you that, this was my favorite camouflaged predator. Okay, you hear me? Hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
This was my favorite camouflaged predator. Okay? I loved the way they made it look. I mean, in every single movie, I love it. You deal with what you got with the technology of the time, and it works. No problem. Never a problem. But there was this thing was really there. Like, I felt like it was there. Like, it was in my room, invisible, but I can see it, but I couldn't see it, you know?
Right.
But then it was that red, staticky electricity that crackled through it. Oh my God, I'm telling you right now, that's my favorite. That that is my favorite.
I thought that was pretty cool too, because we haven't seen that before. It's always been with the blue sparks and stuff.
Yep. Which I'm not mad at.
I don't mind that, but this was really cool seeing that difference.
There's that one particular scene where they're by the way, people, spoiler alert, this is a spoiler review. I should have said that from the jump. But we didn't really get into the spoilers until right now.
You can just put it in the title.
Yeah, you're right. When they're like tied to the tree and it's like that dust storm blows up, the wind kicks up, and all the dirt is in it, so it's making that particle, you know, just, oh God, yeah. I thought that scene, man, I'm sitting there watching that shit. 3 o'clock I started watching it, right? So whatever, that came out 4 o'clock in the morning, let's say. I'm like, oh, it's still dark outside. I don't want, oh my God, I'm gonna put the light on. Oh, that shit scared me, man. Cause I was like, that was such a good scene, man. It was such a great shot. I was like, whoa, could you imagine? Like if I went out in my backyard, I was like, wind is going crazy and I hear my chairs falling out. And so I'm like, what the fuck? So I get up, I open my curtain to the door outside and I look and there's something shimmering. It's a fucking figure shimmering. With all this dirt and shit, I said, nope. I shut the curtain. I go right back in my room.
Yeah, you go back into your room.
Yep. I go under my bed. Yep. Going under the bed. So my wife be like, where are you going? You just stay up there. Cover me. You know? But I thought that was done superbly. Even the ship, the way it drops them off and then it takes back off and kind of just vanishes with that red crackle electricity. I loved that. I loved it. I did. What I didn't like, though, was I don't think it was hot. Like, this wasn't a hot... I didn't watch The Predator, so I don't remember if it was hot in that movie. But I remember in Predators...
they've stopped with the whole hot season... hunting method since
The Predator, because in Predators Adrian Brody, they're like, it's hot here.
Yeah it's since Predators was the last one, but I mean, even though you're not referring to them, but even in Alien versus Predator, well, no, they did do that in Alien versus Predator. In the first one he said it was hot that year. And
yeah, but they were also in the Arctic that whole movie, so that doesn't count.
Yeah.
and they weren't, and the Predators weren't there for the hunt. They were there for a cleanup. Well,
they were there for a try, for a test.
Yeah, true. But
I mean, I would imagine the Great Plains was, and if you think about it, it's during bear and deer season. So true. I guess you could say it's you know, and the rattlesnakes were out. So.
It's lukewarm. It's lukewarm because let's be real, they were up north. They're up north. You know what I'm saying? They're up north. It's lukewarm.
I mean, and back then we didn't have pollution in the air, so I mean that Predator shit probably rose the climate up a lot, but
take that, Earth's atmosphere. But yeah, I mean. Even that little plot thing aside, I just picked up on that in the watching the first two movies and Predators last week, and I was like, oh yeah, that's right. Oh, it gotta be hot. They come out in the heat. I love it. They would never catch me because I hate the heat. I stay inside.
Which is funny because when you bring it up in The Predator, they don't do that because it's fucking Halloween. When the kid's putting on the suit, puts on the helmet, and he blows up that guy's house. It's Halloween.
Oh, I forgot all about that. You know what? Yeah, I really don't
but
like
I mean,
that
it
movie.
Does get hot in Halloween sometimes nowadays, but I
depending on where you at, yeah, it could be. I mean, we had a 80-degree Halloween out here one time. I mean, I don't think that's Predator weather, but it's hot, you know what I mean? But anyway, I digress. Let's back to Prey. What did you think? I mean, I rambled on a lot just now. Before we get into the next things, what did you think of the acting and the setting and the setup?
I loved the whole setting of it. My main issues, honestly, because I'm very, what's the word? I'm very picky about my Predator. I like my Predator to look a certain way. And now here's the thing. It's not that I dislike this Predator. This Predator grew on me a lot when I was watching the film. But I don't feel like this Predator took his equipment based off of the people he was hunting. So when he shows up with this mask with a skull on it, and there's a metal plate behind it, I was like, how the hell can he see behind that mask? Because normally Predators have these mesh visors, but they can still be blocked. And so it was like, unless he was solely relying on heat, which that's probably what it was, I just didn't know, like, how could he see through that mask? Because his eyes were definitely not centered right by his jaws. So I was like, how can he fucking see? So that was kind of weird for me. I do not like the Berserker Predator look, and this Predator did have a Berserker Predator look. Yeah. Now, I mean, the height wasn't the issue or anything. It was, I mean, I guess you could say the face just looked so strange to me. Like, it was just, I don't know, it did not look like a normal Predator we're used to. It looked very more grotesque, which, I mean, that's not an issue for me. I'm not going to dislike a movie because of that. But I will say that it took out for me the mask and stuff because, like, I mean, I like the original Predator. That's who I think should be in every Predator movie. Or a Predator that has a mask that looks like that or a variation of that. That's just me personally, though. I mean, like, Fugitive Predator was a step up in a direction where I was, like, almost not okay. But I thought this movie was fun. It was a fun movie. There were a couple minor things that I thought was weird, like in the beginning when that one tribe member of theirs gets mauled by the mountain lion, they don't even mention him at all after that. They, like, don't even acknowledge that he died.
Yeah, they didn't even acknowledge that he existed. They were just like, oh, yeah, this dude got taken away. And I didn't even know it was, like, I thought it was maybe an animal or a child. And I was like, wait, what?
There was no setup for that. Yeah, well, I'm talking about the guy that was with her when she was hunting the lion.
Oh.
Remember? He got mauled after he was talking shit to her, and that was it. They don't mention him at all after that. Not like, because after she, and even she, after she got knocked unconscious, she was like, well, what happened to, what's his face? Or they don't even mention that he died or what happened. And I thought that, I mean, that was a minor thing. Maybe, I just thought it was kind of funny.
I'm thinking maybe they know. I mean, like, think about it. It's back in the day, Native Americans, these are the things that they would just accept. I think one of the things that I absolutely loved is when the brother told her, this is your moment. And you stand there and you say, you go no further. I love that. So I think maybe they already had peace with, oh, he's not here, he's dead. The damn thing took him. You know?
Yeah.
In a modern setting, yeah, we would be concerned. But with a band of warriors like that, it's a part of the job. It's in the job description. People gonna die.
Aside from all of that, though, my nitpicks, I thought this movie was fun, I thought it was cool, and I thought it was the step in the best direction for Predator to take forward. I wouldn't mind Dan Trachtenberg, or however you say his last name, make another one. I like this movie. I mean, I love that fight with the bear, where the bear mauls him and then he just one punch mans him in the face, knocks him in the dirt. But that fight, man, that fight with all the invaders,
the Spaniards,
the French that come over.
Were they French? I thought they were. Yeah,
I believe they were French. Yeah, they sound like they were speaking French.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. I thought they were Spaniards for whatever reason, but again, 3 o'clock in the morning, I was still groggy.
Yeah, that fight, I want to see Predator do more of that. that That was cool. And his little like knife club that he had, that he just flails up like one of those, like, remember back in the day they had those like wrist bands that you just slap on your arm and they wrap around your wrist.
Yeah.
And like one of those and a blade. I'm like,
and it cauterized wounds too. Like it was, because I remember he used it on somebody and it was just like it heated up and then limb gone. And I was like, oh shit, this thing is crazy.
Yeah. Yeah, dude, that was cool. The Predator tech in this movie was neato, and I like that. We haven't seen that in a while, where Predator plays with some new toys, and I always like seeing Predator do that, because that was one of the things. I mean, the chances are, if you're a Predator fan that grew up in the 90s, you probably played Predator Concrete Jungle, the game. And in the game, there's tons and tons of Predator weapons. Like, the variety is insane. And what's interesting is that in the game, they have a spear gun, and this guy had a spear launcher on his wrist. And that thing was like it was a homing device. And that, I mean, that was cool. That was neato. And then when all those tribe members just get massacred by him, I thought that, I mean, it was fun. Once Predator shows up to do his bidding in this movie, Predator doesn't let up. And I like that. I like that because it keeps you engaged. I was constantly being like, oh man, what's going to go on with Predator stalking them? And, you know, I loved it. I thought it was great. I just had fun with it, you know. And all things aside, Predator look and stuff like that. I mean, yeah, it was a little disappointing, but I'm not going to dislike it, you know, just because, you know, personal taste and difference and stuff. But the one thing to me is this Predator just looked like a Comanche. It looked exactly like how they looked, and that kind of threw me off a little bit when I started thinking about that. But then I'm like, eh, it's okay. It is what it is. It fits the theme of the movie, but... but no, I had fun with it. I thought it was great. You know, all the actors were great. And I appreciate it. I liked it a lot more than I thought I was.
Wow. You carried me up and onto the cliff. Now here's where I got to jump off. I'm going downhill. I didn't like the look of the Predator without the mask. Like I said, I loved the invisible look of the Predator. I loved it. I loved it. When it was invisible and it was roaring, I'm like, wait a minute. It doesn't have a mask. I see his mandibles. What the hell's going on? Does he get that later? Does he kill that bear and put the bear skull on him? Like,
no, it came to Earth with that
and
mask.
Yeah, but I didn't know that because, again, I stayed away from all that shit. I found that out watching the movie. So when he was revealed and he did have that mask and it was a skull, I actually liked that. But then you say, but his eyes didn't even line up where the eyes was. I'm like, fuck, you're right. Okay, maybe the skull is thin right there. I don't know. Maybe it's meshed almost, you know, where he can see through.
He did rely on the technology to see the heat. So maybe it just works with him that way.
And that's the thing that I love, because at first I was like, wait, because I didn't see the metal. You don't really see it until towards, like, the middle, like, when you see him. Because here's the thing, and like you said, yo, once the Predator starts, it really doesn't stop. Like, he's pretty much in this movie. Unlike any of the other movies.
And that was one of the things I loved, not to throw you off, but I loved that he picked from the food chain and went up. When he was hunting things.
Love
first
that.
It was with the rattlesnake, and then the coyote, then the bear, and then, man, that
was a wolf.
Cool.
That was a straight-up wolf. That wasn't a coyote. That was a straight-up wolf.
Oh, yeah, wolf. Sorry.
Yep. I loved
that,
it.
That was cool.
But, yeah, like, I dug it, but I was like, I don't understand how, because, again, they were doing a Predator vision, and I'm like, okay, they nailed that. I hear the Predator vision sound effect. Great. Thank you. It looks great, right? It looks really good. But I'm like, how the fuck? Like, their eyeballs don't see like that. When the Predator takes his mask off in Predator 1, everything goes red. That's all I'm saying. But then later on, when I see, like, the metal behind it, I'm like, oh, he's got a mask on. Oh, I loved it. I fucking loved it.
Yeah, he took paper glue and glued the skull onto it.
But I thought that was, like, I thought that was a really interesting thing for the Predator, because, yeah, you know what? What if that was, like, the best trophy? And he wore that as a badge of honor. You know how, like, let's say back in the days, ancient Greece or something, Hercules, you're a God of War fan, and I'm pretty sure we're going to get into the God of War thing in a minute. You're a God of War fan. Hercules, he killed that lion of whatever the fuck it was, right, and wore it as trophy. Like, yeah, I killed the lion that was killing everybody. This is it. Check it out. It was my pet lion, right? So I love that.
And I even liked, it's funny you bring that up, because even when he's like, when he takes the wolf skull and he like uses that device that he has to make all the flesh melt off of it.
Yep.
I thought, I like that too.
I did too.
I liked seeing that, and then when he clips it on him.
I did too. But I mean, like, you know what bothered me? And you said something earlier. You said maybe this Predator saw what was on this planet and was like, no, I don't need none of this shit. I don't like that. But like what you said, I agree with, because I didn't think of it like that. But I don't like that, right? This Predator came down there fucking buck-ass naked. Literally, he has no armor on. Like he has the wrist gauntlet. There may be a fucking shin gauntlet, but that wolf hit him in the leg and took a chunk. There was blood in the wolf's mouth. That bear hit him, there was blood. I did like that. I did like that this Predator was getting hit. But I'm used to Predators with armor and all this shit, no matter what time frame it is. This is one of those things I say to myself, okay, this is where we need to see a conversation with the Predators, okay? The ones that are dropping them off. And don't tell me you can't do it. You absolutely can do it, okay? If I'm not mistaken, AVPR did it, okay? When they caught the wolf and said, you need to go and exterminate something that is an abomination. If I'm not mistaken, when that translation came up on the screen, it came in the Predator language and then it translated into English so we could see what the fuck they were saying, correct? Am I
wrong? Yeah.
They did that, right? They could have done that here. Why are you going down there like that? Why ain't you taking this? And that's all I needed, honestly, because I'm like, the way I look at it, the way I'm looking at this is, oh yeah, well, we're doing a movie that's like set back then, so maybe the Predator doesn't have the technology. Motherfucker, he flew here in a spaceship. He got the technology. He got the technology. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. It's stupid. It makes me mad.
Plasma-based weapons were definitely a thing, because that ship runs off of that energy.
The crackling off the side, that's plasma energy, man. That's what killed me. I didn't like, I'm going to be 100% honest with you.
I didn't like the darts. Just those weapons he had alone that blew up the forest when all those guys were there and they flew into the sky and there were those mines. Those were plasma-based too.
Yeah. I'm saying, did it blow up the forest? I mean, it made tiny...
Or it made three explosions.
It made three tiny explosions. I was like, okay. I mean, but even then, I didn't think of that as an explosion. I just thought, like, oh, okay. Because my man with the bad teeth came, he missed a leg. I was like, oh, that should just cut his fucking foot off. That's all it did. But yeah, I was, like, I did not like that this thing was so naked, in a sense. And I don't mean like it was naked, but it was naked. But it, without armor or without this high-tech weaponry. A lot of people are like, oh, you really need that? Yeah, no, when it comes to this franchise, you should give me a fucking explanation as to why he's going down there like that. Like you said.
Yeah, that's kind of how I feel.
Like you said, if there was a thing where they did the whole Predator to Predator thing, put your armor on. I don't need it. All I need is this. And he takes the skull and he puts it on and he takes the blunt. Because basically those were blunt weapons. Like, literally. The only thing he had was the dart gun. I didn't even like that. I'm like, but you got the targeting system. Where's your plasma cannon? Don't give me, oh, it wasn't invented yet. No, fuck you. Yes, it was. Because they wouldn't have been able to get off planet. That's it. That bothers me. So if you tell me, if they have a scene and it's like, the Yautjas talking to each other. I don't need it for this. Okay. I'm okay with that. I'm okay with this motherfucker going in.
Bare bones. They call him the feral predator.
I don't want to hear that. I don't see that. Well, but that's the thing. That's the outside thing.
In all of Predator movies, they give the Predators different names, like Fugitive, Berserker, Wolf, Scar, Chopper, blah, 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 and this one was the Feral Predator.
Yeah, okay, but what I'm saying is the first two Predators, they were just Predators. They were, what, the Jungle Predator, the City Predator?
The first Predator in 87 is the Jungle Hunter, and the Predator in Predator 2 is the City Hunter.
That's stupid, though. They're both hunters. The whole race a bunch of hunters. That's the problem. That's why, I mean, like, don't get me wrong. I like the Wolf Predator because he is a cleanup crew, right? Like, I don't know why. I don't even think they ever mention it by name, do they? I don't know. I've watched AVPR three times. And that movie's been out for 20 years. But what I'm saying is, like, I don't care about the names or monikers or these little nicknames because here's the problem. If you start doing that, then you got to do that for this entire fucking race. Don't do that. Don't do it.
Well, so here's the yeah, you're right, and they do, but they do it in the comics and in the books, and that's where most of these guys now making these movies are starting to get a lot of their lore from, is from the books and the comics and the stuff that goes behind the scenes of the movies.
Yeah,
but the thing is they don't acknowledge that in the films.
Right, and that's that, and so that's what I'm saying, like, if it's not acknowledged in the films, I don't care about what it's called. You know what I mean? I don't care if, like, the reason why it has nothing like this is because it's feral. That's what they call it in the script. So, yeah, it's going out there with the bare minimum. I don't care about that. That's not in the movie. You know what I mean? Like, that's right. Not in the movie. Show me a scene. Let me know that this Predator is so fucking badass. It's like, yeah, I don't need that shit. Because this Predator gets its ass handed to it more than any other Predator I've seen in TV. In Predator history.
He gets mauled by a grizzly bear.
Yo, exactly.
He gets fucked up by a grizzly bear.
He gets mauled by a grizzly. He gets bit by the fucking wolf. Homegirl gets her licks in. Her brother fucks his ass up. You know what I'm saying? Hell, even the bunch of fucking, the French pirates, the poachers, whatever they were hitting him. This is a nitpick, but it's justified. Why are you down there basically naked? And why don't you have a plasma cannon? This should be addressed. This should be addressed. Not just because, well, it's the time period. Don't give me that. Don't give me that. They are a fucking space.
The time period has nothing to do with it.
Exactly. They are a space-faring culture. Like, they travel through space. They have technology way beyond our capabilities in the first movie, in the second movie, in the third movie, and in the fourth movie. So don't give me because we go back in time. Oh, no, it's just because, you know, the technology wasn't there. No, yeah, it was. Don't give me that bullshit. Stop the bullshit. Stop it. So that bothered me a lot. Like, a lot. I was just like, oh, motherfuckers, come on. I didn't like the look. I didn't like the hair. I didn't like the fingers. Like, I didn't like it. I love the footprints it left.
Dude, that one scene, if you look, and this was a kind of thing where if you pause, you would have noticed, but I think it was right after the scene when he kills all of the invaders. You can see him doing something. I think he's cleaning his wounds or something, and you can see the glove of his suit, of the suit they chose, and it was so flabby. And
yes.
I was like, whoa.
He was cauterizing a wound. Yes. He was cauterizing a wound. I did notice that. See, and that's the thing. It's like, come on. Don't be like, oh, well, it's just going to Hulu. It don't really matter. No, it fucking does to the people who love
this franchise. Disney Plus, too.
I didn't see it on Disney Plus. I went
it came out after midnight.
I was on this morning, and I didn't see it on Disney Plus. It wasn't like on the main. I think really? Episode. Yeah. I did not see it. I went on this morning.
Even Predator, like the Prey page, even just said now on Hulu and Disney Plus.
Maybe it's on now, but literally at like 6:45 in the morning. No, I'm lying. It was after that. It was like 7:45 in the morning. It wasn't there. But it doesn't matter. I seen it on Hulu, so. But yeah, man, it was those things. I didn't like the face because I don't like the Berserker look. the hair. The hair especially kind of bothered me because I'm so used to like
the rings, and it didn't have the rings.
Yeah, I like the rings and the thickness of the hair. They're like dreadlocks. This shit looked like dirty spaghetti noodles. I was like, the fuck is this?
It's like the spaghetti made from the octopus ink.
Yes, exactly. Yep. This shit looked like Play-Doh. Not even Play-Doh. It looked like Play-Doh.
You know what? I'm on Disney Plus right now looking for Prey, and it's not there. That's weird.
Yeah.
There must be something going on where they're not, because I don't get why Prey would even say it's there if it's not.
Oh, you know why? Because I think for maybe markets that don't have access to Hulu in other countries and stuff, but Disney Plus is there.
There was something that said UK, but
yeah. So I think that's what that meant. But
oh well, it's free on Hulu. But anyways, yeah, I wanted this Predator to have armor too. I always want Predator to have armor. Yeah, I mean, some of my favorite armors. I mean, I love the Wolf Predator armor, even though it's minimal. But I do love the Scar Predator armor from the first Alien vs. Predator movie. I like the bulkiness and the, you know, we are, you know, full of weaponry and full body armor and stuff, like we're Ronin samurai type things. I think that's cool, but Predator needs armor. That's a must, and he needs his plasma caster. Yeah, that's also a must.
naked Predator just don't work. I will say too. I was like, you know, another thing that kind of like, come on, y'all, come on. When he goes for his gauntlet, and he starts to do whatever commands he does on his gauntlet, the gauntlet looked like it was old. And again, this is something I'm like, it shouldn't look like that. It should look like it did in Predator 1, 2, 3, 4. It should look like a normal gauntlet. Because again, these things are advanced fucking beings. They're an advanced civilization. Don't try to mimic the time. Don't do that. Don't. Because it's only a couple of hundred years later. And these dudes already have space fucking travel. Don't. Invisibility cloaks. Don't do that. That bothers me. That really, really pisses me off. You sent me the a YouTube fan film last week.
Dark Ages.
Dark Ages. That Predator was fully equipped. So, you see how they get it right? That's what the fans do. They know. They understand. Like, no. It could be medieval fucking times. These dudes come from space. They flew here from another planet. They've conquered other civilizations. They have the weaponry. Now, whether they choose to use it or not, that's the interesting part. That's what I would like to see. If this Predator came down here fully loaded, assessed the situation and said, you know what? Fuck this, fuck this, fuck this, and fuck this, and just dropped everything, right?
Or just put it back in his locker.
Yeah.
His little trunk under his bed.
Yeah. Then I'm like, oh, that's dope. You know, he realizes, oh, okay. Because, okay, I remember in the beginning I said I got nothing bad to say about the first Predator movie. I lied. There is a nitpick. That motherfucker is way OP. Way OP. That motherfucker is overpowered. He didn't need none of that shit to kill these people. He didn't need none of that shit to kill these people. I said to myself, good God almighty. Maybe Jesse the Body Ventura because he had the goddamn minigun. Maybe him because he had the minigun, right? But outside of Mac picked up the minigun. Outside of him, he could have came down and slaughtered each and every one of them without even using the plasma cannon. Now, in 1997, different story. I mean, this is gang warfare. Like, nobody gave a shit, right? So he sees all right, okay. Yeah. The scene on the train was the perfect scene because when he gets on, like, before he gets on there, the guy was trying to rob the other guy who was playing with the other guy, and everybody pulled out a gun. Everybody, even the little old lady. And what happened?
Yeah.
They all died. They all died. He killed them all because they were armed. In the jungle, and he didn't even blow him up with a plasma cannon. He straight up gunned him. That was my thing. I'm like, so that's my one gripe with the first Predator movie. You didn't need all that shit to kill these people, except for Jesse.
You look like a sentimental dude.
Come on, man. Like, just cut their fucking heads off with your awesome Wolverine claws. I mean, come on. But you know, I digress. The Predator look aside, right? And my technology issues aside, I did have fun with this movie. She's Batgirl, I'll tell you that. The homegirl was killing it with that damn tomahawk when she tied the string. I know you've been chomping at the moment to say that shit. Go ahead.
It's her Kratos blade. the chains of chaos. Blades of chaos.
It literally was like both of them in one, right? It was the axe and the blades in one.
You know, yeah, I loved that. I loved, and I know Dan T said that, you know, this movie was highly influenced from the 2018 game. But I didn't think it was going to be like that. But then it comes to the notice of, like, I get kind of giddy because the brother has the white ash-looking paint on him with the red marks. Yes. And I'm like, I wonder if that's a nod to Kratos.
Has to be.
And I'm like, it has to be. And I love that. I love that. And, I mean, I love the little stuff like that. And the fact that, you know, the God of War story is about the bear and the wolf. And the Predator kills the wolf and the bear. And
I mean, even the brother is like a Kratos archetype. You know, he becomes the war chief.
Basically, yeah.
For killing the lion, you know. And even though Kratos is a crazy motherfucker, at the end of the day, he's kind of humble. You know what I mean? And I'm not talking 2018 Kratos. I'm talking Kratos in general. You know what I mean? Kratos, the leader of the Spartan army. He's nuts, but he's also humble, like in the silent moments. That's where I saw this dude. I was like, oh, yeah. But I didn't even recognize the ashy with the red. Now that you said that, I'm like, oh, that was totally Kratos.
Yeah. And I love it. I love those little Easter eggs. But one thing too is the brother, man. He didn't fear Predator.
No,
that was interesting. He did not really seem afraid of this thing at all.
No, and I think that, listen, and that's one of the things about this movie that I did enjoy a lot. Again, like I said, once the Predator gets there, you know what I'm saying? Because it's there. But once it gets there, it's there all the time. It doesn't leave. It's constant. If it's gone, it's gone for 2-3 minutes, and then it's back, and it's nonstop. And I like that. I loved the play, the play on the whole "I can't see you" bit, right? Because they play us in the beginning. She falls in the quicksand. It's all mud. She's doing her Batgirl routine. She finally gets the grappling hook into the tree. And she pulls herself out, and she's full of mud. And you're like, oh my god. The Predator's not going to be able to see her because she got mud on her. And then the next scene, she's washing herself off. I'm like,
yeah.
What?
Yeah, I like that. I'm glad they didn't do that. That's been so hashed.
But I like that because that's a thing. But this is where I was like, oh my god. The creativity. Because it's right in the beginning of the movie, and I didn't pick up on it. When she gives him the orange flower, the kid that got mauled by the lion, and he's like, I'm freezing. They all cover him. She was like, don't cover him. You want him to die? Like,
yeah.
Let him suffer through this. I thought that was fucking genius. I didn't even know until Homeboy with the Bad Teeth and the Easter egg. Ugh, I hated it. And the Easter egg.
What Easter egg?
You know what Easter egg. Come on, don't play like you don't know. Homeboy with the Bad Teeth gave her what? The gun.
Gave her the gun.
And it's exactly the same
gun. Yeah. I was waiting for us to touch on that.
We're gonna get to that in a second. But I'm saying,
I remember talking to you about that a while ago.
and I brushed it off because I remember I said I don't want to know yet. But when she gave him the flower, the orange flower, and the Predator couldn't see him, I loved it. I was like, oh my god. When he played dead, I was like, that's fucking genius. And then the Predator steps on him. It wasn't on purpose. He was just walking. That had me in tears. I was like, no! He's like, oh! And then, boom, Predator just kills him.
Yeah.
But, when she did it, man, I can't lie, man. That was some good shit right there. When she was there, and the Predator was gunning for her, and she was hiding at first. This is before she took it. And he was like, I got her. And all of a sudden, the brother came out of nowhere. Bro, I was screaming. I was like, yo, get it! And his war cry. And I was like, yeah, let's go! That brought me back to Predator 2. The emotion. And you know what I mean? That this movie was really... The acting was well done.
It was. I have no complaints in the department of the actors chosen for this movie or that was choreographed. It was awesome.
Yeah, I think they really hit it on the head. Everybody all around, the whole team, from directors, the actors, all that, everything. The war cries. Man, I was in.
Yeah. And you know what's cool is, if I remember right, apparently all of those main actors are legitimately, they have indigenous DNA backgrounds.
Yeah, I think that's exactly, well, they all look like they did. And even,
yeah.
I looked up her today, and she, and I don't mean this in a negatory way, but she's a mutt. She's got, like, Native American, European, Chinese, like, she's all over the place. I'm like, oh my god, beautiful woman, great actress. She fucking nailed it. Like I said, one or two times, maybe three times, she did a little something that was modern. I was like, no. But for the most part, I was like, oh, I'm on board with her. But when my man went out, when her brother went out, bro, fucking champion. That was one of my dude. Oh, how about the homage to Billy? When they had him in the cage, they pull him out and they cut his chest. I said, oh my god, this is Billy.
Oh,
Billy's great ancestors.
I wasn't even thinking about that.
Oh yeah, no, that's, dude, straight up, same cut and everything. I said, look at this. Billy, listen. Billy, mother, oh god. It was so good. Poncho, I miss Poncho. That Adrian Brody, Poncho looking motherfucker. Anyhow, yeah, when her brother went out, he went out like the war chief. He said, I go no further. He said, I go no further. This is it for me. I stop here. Run. Oh my god. And then the kill. Predator hooked him. Put the Wolverine through him. Picked his ass up. And this Predator, like you said, he was a big dude. This was a really big Predator. And I like that. And again, I guess that's that Berserker mode Predator shit. You know what I mean? Because they're like unusually big.
I don't mind Predator being that way. I just don't want them that way because they experimented on other Predators and put their DNA with that in their, you know, or you know, they're trying to prey on other smaller Predators, you know.
No, I agree with that.
Even though I love Predators and I love those three Berserker Predators in that movie, but...
No, I do agree with that, but at the same time, if that was the case, then you got the technology to, I don't know, splice DNA, but you can't make a plasma cannon on your shoulder.
Come right.
On. I'm just saying.
And the other thing, too, for me is when they say Predator, the ultimate hunter, and, you know, and we're familiar with the normal size Predator, the bigger Predators would, to me, be the alphas. And that, to me, would be like, wouldn't that make them the ultimate ones we would see often? And so I just don't like that idea.
Yeah, I don't either. And that's again, that's one of those things where I'm like, and this goes back to when they first started to change the look of the Predator, which was what? In Predators, right? Like, they changed...
Yeah, Predators. Predators was the first time.
I didn't like it because I'm saying to myself, and don't get me wrong here, everybody's different. In humanity, we all look different. We all have different fingerprints. There's something like fucking snowflakes. I get that. And homie, snowflakes, like, you know what I'm saying. But grains of sand, for instance. We all have a different something about ourselves that will distinguish us.
Right.
So, I mean, it could be from the looks. It could be from your skin color. It definitely comes from a fucking fingerprint. So I'm not mad at the idea of what if the Predator was like that. Look, I'll never be opposed to a female Predator. Because they got to come from somewhere. It can't be.
And they do have female Predators, but we just haven't seen them in.
Exactly. The movie. I mean, like, they can't do like Man of Steel and just like birth these things from a fucking birthing tubes where they just put DNA and say, oh, all right, make it thick. I wouldn't be opposed. So, yeah, I can definitely see different looks, but when you start going into... Because, again, the whole idea of the Predator species is they're hunters, right? Unless you get a fucking movie where you don't see that, where you see the scientists who built the technology, the people that got the farm to feed these hunters, every time they come back, what's the hierarchy? How does this thing work? I never want to know anything about that. I never do. I just want to see a hunter going to Earth, or hell, even another planet, and doing its thing until it can't do it no more. That's all I want to see. That's what this franchise is built upon. Do that. It's a simple fucking formula. It's simple. This movie nailed it, right? The formula was simple. They used the formula. They nailed it. It's just cosmetic. I don't like the cosmetics. I don't like the look of this Predator. I don't like that it looks like this Berserker thing. But again, if you tell me, well, you know, Predators are going to have different looks. It's not a clan. Like, what do they call it? You play Dungeons and Dragons. So, like, what do they... Is it clans? What do they call the different...
It'd be like class.
Yeah, it's not a different class. Because if that was the case, you would have a military. You would have all this stuff, right? You would have your regular Army Rangers. You would have your Navy SEALs, you know, you would have your freaking, like, you would have these things. And I'm sitting there and I'm like, but why would you need that? That's why I don't ever want to see that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
No, they just go out, they do the hunt thing. That's their thing. They come home and maybe they are farmers. You know what I'm saying? Like, maybe they are farmers. I mean, there are millions of people here in the United States of America who could be your next door neighbor, just the coolest dude in the world. And you never know that. He goes up to the mountains and he picks off deer with a bow and arrow. You know what I mean? And he brings it home, right? and he's got food for fucking a year. And he gives you freaking jerky. And you're like, oh, damn, that's delicious. Where'd you get it from? Oh, yeah, I got that one. You never know. But I don't want
to
say
it. We used to have a neighbor that actually did that.
Yeah. But
so it's funny you say that.
But like in terms of the Predator, like I don't want to see that. Like I don't want to see this system. Predator 2 was a perfect example of that, where they had the Predators at the end come out.
And even,
yeah, and even though it was supposed to be the, I'm going to get to that in a second. Even though it was supposed to be the one that Danny Glover killed, right, was supposed to be pretty much the captain of that ship. It was his hunt. It was his crew. You had those elders there. I love that, you know?
Yeah.
What was the one common denominator, though, with all of those predators? They all looked the same.
Yeah, they had a few that had different masks and different.
No, no, I'm talking about like the facial structures. Like they resembled. This one might have looked a little bit older. They weren't really far out there. Like again,
I gotcha.
These, I don't know, what Berserker Predators, man? No. I'm not a fan, man. I'm not a fan. Just make them look like just classic Predators, you know? Because then you have to introduce, again, like I said, you have to introduce this whole system. Why are there these ultimate hunters? Why are these alphas around? What is the need for it? Are they policing what the hunt should be? That doesn't make sense.
I don't like it.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense. So I get frustrated with shit like that, man. I do. And again, that's why I don't like the change to the looks of the Predator. Just make them look the same. Mm-hmm. And if you want to do something different, man, like make one look younger, make one look older, make one have fucking facial hair. Who knows? Maybe somebody has a scary stash. That would be funny.
And see, in the lore, in like the books, predators are immortal. They live thousands of years. They don't die of old age.
They just die if they get killed.
Yeah, they just die if they get fucking axed.
I like that, and I don't think thousands, but definitely, like, I could see a predator live into like 300. You know?
Yeah.
That would work for me. That would be perfect in my eyes. But I don't, you know, I've read two books way back when, like the first two Alien versus Predator novels. I own those. I read those. Where the girl on the colony is on the colony that everything went haywire with, wind up joining the predators at the end. That aside, let's talk about the end of this movie, and then we're going to get into the Easter eggs and all that shit before we wrap up. I thought, in all honesty, that this was the best. Because I fell asleep for Predators, and I don't remember, and I definitely don't remember the Predator, but I thought this was the best kill scene for a Predator since Predator 2.
It was definitely different.
Because she worked with what she had.
Yeah.
And I love that because what she had was, again, sticks and stones. Well, and then his technology, but...
She stole the mask and...
The shot in the back of the head was dope. I can't lie. I was like, oh, all right, yeah. Cool, you know? But that the fact that that thing got up and was like, no. But when it fell into the quicksand, I was like, okay, that's not how that dies. And then when it comes up, I'm like, okay, that works. And then the homing device thing. Again, I didn't like the darts. I wasn't a fan of the darts. I really wasn't. I really wish that would have been explained. Again, I mean, maybe I needed exposition or maybe I needed explosions. Probably the latter. You would have put one giant explosion.
He wasn't able to set off his wrist bomb.
Because he played himself. He played himself. He's like, oh, I don't need it. You fucking idiot.
Yeah, I called Predator a fucking idiot.
It is what it is. I mean, he wasn't.
Oh, I love it.
He wasn't in a dire situation. That's what pissed me off. He wasn't in a dire situation. When Predator 2 started to put the wrist bomb tick, Danny Glover said, oh, no, you don't. And cut his fucking hand off. Just on principle. That was cool, though. He was getting amputated. And again, I will say, I really love that this Predator was getting fucked up. It didn't seem like it. It was feeling it. But, oh, my God. This thing got, it got torn into, you know?
It was a very durable Predator.
Definitely. Definitely.
I mean, just for the fact that it got attacked by a grizzly and it didn't really look like it was bleeding much after that.
I really wish I would have seen it take the grizzly's head.
Yeah, that would have been cool.
Yeah, I think we deserve, especially in this type of movie, because let's say Predators and the Predator really wasn't about trophies. Well, Predators were, but they were more like, you're on our planet now. This one was about trophies. This one was about trophies.
You know what would have been cool now that you say that? I think you would feel differently, but I almost wish Predator took the skull of the brother right in front of her.
Ooh, no, I feel different.
That would have made it personal. that would have made it personal, and I would love that.
Well, no. He did, though. He didn't take the skull in front of her. But remember, he put them in the Wolverine claws, thought he was dead, and he fucking stabbed it. While hanging in the claws, or did he drop him? But he was pretty much, that's right. And then the Predator cut its head off. He cut his head
off. Yeah, that's true.
And he did it in front of her, so she was mad. I mean,
but imagine like if he ripped out the spinal cord with the skull on, like he did to the wolf in front of her. She would have been like, uh-oh, this is personal now.
Yeah. Oh, you know, man.
Which ended up being personal anyways, but it would have been... I think for me as an audience, though, it would have been more like, oh my God, now she has hateful vendetta.
Yeah, I like that she used that last French guy as bait. And I like that she... And again, a lot of people are going to say, oh, she Mary Sued it. Not really. She understood what was what. She understood what this thing was from the jump, because you got to remember, too, like, their track is they are hunters themselves. Like, that's what Native Americans were. That's what they did, you know?
Yeah.
And it's like, anybody, like, dude, it's not even just the Native Americans. Again, this shit goes across all spectrum of humanity. At a certain point in time, this is what humanity did. It didn't matter what you were, what continent you were on, what race. This is what we did together. We hunted. As soon as we got that brain, we were hunters. So I love that, you know, they were using this and she was able to piece it together. Like, okay, he's going after people who have weapons. So she left an unloaded weapon. Why was it unloaded? How did she know? Because my guy with the bad teeth told her what the fuck to do.
Simple. That's the reason. You know, I'm thinking about all this with the pistol and everything. I'm like, why'd they give it back to Danny Glover? It's probably because they didn't know how to use it.
So, all right, I guess we'll get to that right now. My man with the bad teeth gives her the pistol, shows her how to use it. I seen it. As soon as he threw it to her, I said, oh my God, you serious? That's the Predator 2 gun. Duh, motherfuckers. You can't make, listen to me, you can't make something like that. So what that meant in that moment in Predator 2 was the fucking superior race, literally, because that's what they were. I don't care what anybody says. They have a spaceship. We don't. The superior race was like, we acknowledge you for killing this motherfucker right here. Because he was a bad motherfucker. So here, take it. Right?
Right.
And he looks at the gun and it says 17, 15, whatever the fucking name was. And there's the gun in this movie. And I'm like, why? Why? There's no significance to this gun. For this movie.
It wasn't from like a famous pirate or a famous killer or anything like that. It wasn't like from Columbus or anything.
Right. And then the question comes to beg, well, how did they get the gun?
Yeah, how did they get it back?
And they never got it back because they never had it to begin with. Was it a trophy? I'll tell you what it was. I can guarantee you this. Somebody told that one predator who lived 300 years later, 400-500 years later, someone told them from that tribe, take it. And you know that's what the Predator thing is. The repeat.
Oh my God. We're setting up sequels.
I'm just saying. But at the same time, it was unnecessary. It was so unnecessary. It was there as an Easter egg. I respected it because that's why, one of those reasons why I do love Predator 2. I love the idea. We not only saw the trophy room, we saw multiple predators in the ship, and they recognized, okay, you won, we're out. Take it. Here's a souvenir. And it literally is a fucking souvenir. It's not like they dropped a fucking, I don't know, a Glock 9 or Glock, you know, whatever. I don't know. I'm just making up.
Smith and Wesson, Colt 45.
Yeah, they didn't give him a gun that was only like 20, 30 years old. No, they gave him a gun that was 300-400 years old. I love that. In that movie, it was so unnecessary in this one. So unnecessary. It was just there as an Easter egg. But again, well, where do we go from here? Do we really make a sequel and base that gun as a thing? What the fuck? What? No.
Yeah.
No, 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 no. So again, while I did enjoy it, at the same time, man, it's a seesaw with me. It ain't my favorite. Not by far. I'll watch it again. Maybe twice. But I don't even think I need to watch it twice. It did what it needed to do. Visually, I was pleased. Literally, everybody crushed it in their roles. The Predator was cool, but at the same time, not my type of Predator. I don't like that look. I will say this. Actually, I will say one thing. That, man, listen, she can't run. She should have been dead 1,000 times. She was basically Kong in Godzilla vs. Kong in this movie. She should have been dead. She couldn't run.
Well, she ran faster than that guy that got killed in the fields.
Did you see how fast that Predator was running?
Oh, yeah.
He should have been on her way before her leg got caught in that trap.
I mean, you're talking an 8-foot super species.
I'm just saying, that dude was Captain America on steroids. So I'm just saying, like, he was a fast motherfucker.
I think for the future going forward, let's stick with the smaller predators, or at least make them more normal. No berserker predators, and let's just bring back the plasma caster.
Bring it back. All right, real quick. The gun was an Easter egg. There was two lines dropped that I wanted to just choke my fucking self. If it bleeds, we could kill it. Terribly delivered. I will say. Yeah,
terribly delivered.
As much as I love the acting, that was... It felt forced. Like, you gotta say this. And he was like, really? You gotta say this. And then when at the end, when she was like, come on, I'm here. What are you waiting for? I'm like, no. No, 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 no. Don't do that. All right? You need an accent to do that. You have to have that Austrian... Yeah, you need to have that Austrian accent. You need to be like, I'm here. What are you waiting for? Do it. Kill me now. Like, you need that.
You have to really have that nasal and popcorn stuck in your throat.
Bro, you sure the fuck do. But, I mean, again, I enjoyed it. For what it was, it's a seesaw. There's a lot of ups. There's a shit ton of downs. It was not bad, though. I would recommend people to watch it at least once. Like, no, give it a shot. You know? Like, watch it.
I would say that's fair for any Predator fan to watch it once. I mean, like I said, it's not the perfect Predator movie. It's not the worst Predator movie, but it's a step in the right direction.
Exactly. And don't, for whatever reason, God, please, don't say this was the first time they were on the planet. Don't do that. Don't do that. You need to leave that open. I mean, look, I'm not religious, but... Have Predator come down during them days. I'm not saying Predator versus Jesus. No. But I'm saying you can do something in that timeline. That's how far you can go back. Like, you could just go back. You could go back to... Anybody watching Primal right now? Like, anybody seen Primal? You know what I'm talking about. You could go back to the caveman days. You can do these things. There's so much history.
And now I kind of want to watch Predator kill a T-Rex.
Lord have mercy on my soul. I mean, if they're killing alien queens, why can't they kill a T-Rex?
Well, they have in the books, but...
I got to read that book now. I want to see that visually, though.
There's some cool stuff like that. But, yeah, I mean, look, I would love... You know, I'm playing Ghost of Tsushima right now. Or Ghost of Tsushima, sorry. I would love to see Predator in, like, the Chinese invasion, fighting samurais and stuff, or, you know, Ronin and warlords like that. I think that would be awesome.
Again.
Back when our wars were primal and not based off of that type of stuff. I mean, yeah, Predator would have his plasma caster and he would, you know.
He could get rid of it.
But.
They're smart. He could get rid of it. He could say, okay, I see the playing field. Right. And if I want the honor of this trophy, I'll take that off. That's what he did to Dutch in Predator 1. He took everything off. He said, all right, let's go.
Yep. It's mano a mano.
Yeah, and it's perfect. And it's perfect.
No, I think I like the movie. I liked it a lot better than I thought I would. I'm glad that it was better than I thought. My only thing is really just, this Predator needs some tweaking, needs a better, for me, a better mask and some armor and his plasma caster.
I agree. Did you watch the credits as they rolled, or did you shut it off when it's finished, as soon as the credits started?
I didn't watch I fast forward the credits, but I didn't watch them, so I don't know if there's anything there.
There's nothing. There's, like, literally, visually nothing as soon as the credits start rolling when it fades to black. But the animation, did you watch all that to the end?
No.
So at the end of the animation, right, they basically show the movie in succession through animation. And then you see, towards the end, you see her coming with the Predator head, right?
Yeah.
And then the last thing you see is, like, they start pointing to the sky. And you see, like, a kid run or something, somebody running. And then the ships, plural, start coming from the sky in the animation.
Oh, okay.
And then it fades to black. And I'm like, of course! That's exactly how you gotta do it.
All right. Well, cool. Yeah. I didn't notice that.
Yeah, no, I... Man, I kept that shit running. I was like, oh, no, we're going to watch this whole fucking thing. So I'm already up. And I got work in about an hour. So I'm already up. We're going to watch this. I'm going to take a shower and I'm going to get ready for work. But, yeah, but that's it, man. I mean, like, yeah. Overall, where do you put this movie in the franchise?
Predator 1, 2, Predators, and then Prey.
Okay, that's fair. That's fair. Predator 1 and 2 is equal, and then there's everything else.
Yeah, pretty much.
That's the way I like it.
But I mean, like, you have to ask yourself, do you like Predators or Prey better?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I'm gonna finish off Predators. I'm gonna go back, I'm gonna watch it, I'm gonna watch it till it's over, and then I'm gonna watch The Predator, and then I'm gonna watch Prey again. That's what I'm gonna do. That's how I'm gonna end this night. And on that note, that's how we're gonna end this podcast. So, G73, thank you for joining me.
Oh, absolutely, it was a fun one.
Yeah, this was a good one. I definitely enjoyed it. And ladies and gentlemen, thank you all out there for joining us on our Prey review. I am G1. This is G Show Podcast, and we are out here. Take it away, G73.
I don't know what to sing.
Play the music. Thank you. Now play the music. We out of here. Peace.